Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about various methods that are used for synthesis of petrol. There are three different methods that are used for the synthesis of petrol or gasoline, that is polymerization method, Fischer-Tropsch method and Burgess process. Let us discuss all these three methods in detail. First is the polymerization method. In this method, as the name suggests, smaller molecules of hydrocarbons are combined to get heavier molecule which resembles with that of gasoline. For example, we have propene and butene at pressure, heat and catalyst. This will be converted into a compound which is resembling with that of gasoline. So we have two different types of polymerization, thermal polymerization and the other one is catalytic polymerization. In thermal polymerization, we do the polymerization at high temperature, that is about 500 to 600 degrees centigrade temperature and a pressure of about 70 to 350 kg per centimeter square. Whereas in catalytic polymerization, we use a catalyst like phosphoric acid and the temperature will be of 150 to 200 degrees centigrade and at a lower pressure, the smaller molecules will be converted into polymerized into the corresponding gasoline molecules. The gasoline so obtained will be of better quality and it will have good anti-knock properties as compared with that of the gasoline obtained from the thermal polymerization process. The second method that is used is Fischer-Tropsch method. In this method, we use carbon monoxide and hydrogen and we do the catalytic reduction to get straight chain alkane and olefins, which is similar with that of the gasoline or petrol. This is a diagram in which we have purification chambers, we have compressor here, we have catalytic chamber, cooler, and the fractionating column. So let us discuss the method in detail. A mixture of water gas, that is carbon monoxide and hydrogen, with excess of hydrogen is passed through these purification chambers. Here we have, in the first chamber we have Fe2O3 and in the second chamber we have Fe2O3 and sodium carbonate. These two chambers will help in removal of sulfur and sulfur compounds. The mixture after removal of sulfur and its compound, it is compressed at 5 to 25 atmospheric pressure and it is forced to the catalytic chamber. We use a catalyst as cobalt, thoria, magnesia and kieselguhr. All these compounds will be in a specific ratio, that is mixture of cobalt as 100 parts, thoria about 5 parts, magnesia 8 parts and kieselguhr earth, which is nothing but a silica content, that is a 200 parts. This mixture will act as catalyst. Now, at a temperature of about 200 to 250 degrees centigrade, the reaction will take place and will form saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons and the process is exothermic in nature. So the products will be sent into the cooler. Here we can see the reactions that is taking place. We get alkanes and alkenes which is of similar with that which will have similar qualities with that of gasoline will be obtained and heat is liberated because it is an exothermic reaction. So we are using cooler and the products will be again sent into fractionating column and we get the main constituent as gasoline and the heavier portion as heavy oil. This heavy oil will be cracked to get the gasoline again. The third method that we use to get petrol or gasoline is Burgess process. Here we convert the low-graded coals such as bituminous coal and lignites into the liquid and gaseous fuel by hydrogenating them in the presence of catalyst. The catalysts that we use here are generally nickel or tin oleate. Here we take the mixture of heavy oil, powdered coal, low-graded coals and catalyst mixture. It will be sent into the converter and then into the cooler or condenser and then into the fractionating column. Let us discuss the process in detail. In this process, the powdered coal, this is a powdered coal, this will be mixed with heavy oil and the catalyst, that is nothing but tin or nickel oleate. And this paste will be treated or heated with hydrogen for at a temperature of 450 degrees centigrade and at a pressure of 250 atmosphere for half an hour in the converter. Then after that, the products, here the complete reaction will take place and the products will be sent into the condenser or cooler. Then again from the cooler, the products will be sent into the fractionating column where we get different products. The uncondensed gases will be removed as usual in the fractionating column and the main product we get as gasoline. And the next product what we get will be hydrogenated to get gasoline, and that is nothing but the middle oil. This will have lesser amount of hydrogen, so we hydrogenate it to get gasoline. And the heavier part, which we call it as the heavy oil, this will be sent into the first container and it will be used to make paste for the next process. That's all for today. Thank you, everyone.